going back to the 1990s with one of the generals of that era, a cloud of controversy. Vershon clears the air.
Right now, I'm just the mercy of God.
Meet the son of Sizzla Kalonji.
Yeah.
Who is booked to perform at Reggae Sumfest. Tifa is featured in a new video. But who is the owner? She'll be here to tell us. Sumfest Revitalizes lead up events, the big concert night, and more. All coming up right here on our stage. Welcome to the show, everyone. I am Winford Williams. We'll be right back.
I say we at the right place.
Reaching more and more screens around the world every week. On stage, so much more than entertainment.
Reggae Sumfest has always been a week-long festival. Not much is reported about the events leading up to the big concert nights. That, it appears, is being addressed this year. On set right now to tell us more about the big changes coming and the promotional plan to lift the profile of the events leading up to the big nights is Francine Messier, right now, right here on our stage.
Hi, Winfrey.
Francine, so good to have you.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, so speak about that. What exactly will you be doing to raise the profile of these events?
Well, there have been a number of changes made in terms of even the look and feel of every event leading up to Sumfest. Starting with our kickoff event on the 16th, the beach party, it's changed location. It's now at the new and improved Tropical Bliss Beach, and that's in White House, Montego Bay. Fabulous location, beautiful white sand beach, excellent views. And so it's a pleasure actually to be able to set up in an already beautiful space. Okay. We're gonna have beautiful people there, lovely, you know, beach bunnies. We're gonna have the lovely Yanni, the curvy diva there. It's gonna be an exciting.
Yeah, so the beach.
The beach party is our kickoff.
Yes, and it wasn't it always so? A beach party kicking off the week?
Yes. Okay. But this year it's bigger. We have cabanas now, VIP cabanas. It's a new addition to the experience
For that particular event.
And then,
go on.
And then we go into our sunset boat ride party, which kicks off from Pier 1 the following day. And that's a night event that starts at 7 p.m. We go out to sea and we sail and enjoy music until 11 p.m. and we come back and have an after party at Pier 1.
Okay.
So that's the second night, the 17th.
The 17th. And
right?
The 18th?
On the 18th, it's our all white party. That is a staple for Sumfest every year. People look forward to that. Crowds come out for that. So definitely, we're going to not disappoint. We're going to improve. We're going to make everything feel and look much different than it has ever looked before. Blitz now is gonna be at the Pier 1 Entertainment Center. It is a 90s event, it's retro, so it's all about, you know, all of the old dance hall music that we all grew up and love to listen to, the 90s genre. The selectors are gonna be amazing. It's gonna give you that throwback feel. And then the following night after that, we have our Sound Clash. And that's going to be amazing. It's going to be international sound systems. They'll be coming from all over the globe, from as far as Japan and Germany. And we'll see who the winner is.
And that's Pier 1?
That is also at Pier 1. And then we move right into the two nights of our
festival. To the big nights.
To the big nights.
Big dance all night on Friday.
Massive dance all night on Friday.
And then the conclusion, the grand finale.
On the 22nd.
The 22nd. So what's the vibe now in relation to your projections, your numbers, your bigger, better Sumfest objective?
Well, you know what? I believe our social media presence is extremely strong and we've got a lot of feedback from our patrons there. We have on the ground, I mean, patrons are hitting us up all the time for, you know, cabana sales are moving, ticket sales are moving, whether online or otherwise. So we think we're very much on target, and we expect everything to be completely full.
Francine, all that is left then is for us to head down tomorrow.
You need to come and make sure I see you there.
Oh, well, you know, we don't miss Sumfest ever, so we'll be there. And a And as usual, we're carrying all the big events of the weekend.
Yes.
That's all night. And of course, the grand finale on Saturday.
On Saturday.
Thank you so much for coming.
Nice to see you. Thank you.
And we should be together, but you just drive me crazy. And now that we are together,
the energy god Elephant Man jumps into the song of the summer contest with this joint, Jamaica Jamaica, that takes our video stage this week.
Yo, how would this be?
Summer is on, energy god, Elephant Man, get your bike here, riff, Negrilla do it,
yep,
I'm out, shizzle.
I don't know if you can make it.
Come on.
But if you can, you better catch a plane real quick. If you are here, then you fi catch a spaceship.
Yep.
Talks about the sexy girl, them just a shake it. Yeah. Welcome to Jam Down.
Yeah.
Landing I'm up, yeah, you have to come a town too. Oh. Them never know I so down your knife. Oh, Jamaica, Jamaica.
Jamaicans all over.
Boss a blank represent to no country.
Put them up.
I see everybody and we have the flags there.
New York, Connecticut, Washington, D.C.
And make the world
London.
Know who we are.
Canada.
Oh, Jamaica, Jamaica. Don't you nicer than
Miami, eh? Orlando, all over.
We'll survive through all the war day.
Give thanks to the Most High.
So me happy, thank you, Father.
Yeah.
Now say hello, yo.
Hands up. From on the road.
The last time we check it out, no way no better than ya, man. We got live better than somebody we up a brand.
Yo, who say Jamaica no knife, took me them a cry.
Yeah.
Now go run with pan no farmer, we get no car.
No. Hustle, make the money, say me back a yard.
Yeah.
Pick up the yardy, them where you walk in a garage. And the one them in a foreign metal security guard.
Yo,
now go follow bad company, pick up the charge.
No, no, now sell out, pick up foreign and no way. Now you must call Jamaica knife, you must need that. True, how the girl them road, you not breathe that. Girl, I back it up, you know see.
Come. Yeah,
we not change, we in the same. We are we bad, yeah, we bound with it, now we the end here.
Yeah.
Put up your hand in the ear like a ear. Put up what's up, black
me now.
Jamaica, Jamaica.
All right, stay with us. Still to come right here on stage, going back to the 1990s live with one of the generals of that era, a cloud of controversy. Vershon clears the air. Meet the son of Sizzla Kalonji, who is booked to perform at Reggae Sumfest. And Tifa is featured in a new video. But who is the owner?
Reaching more and more screens around the world every week. On stage, so much more than entertainment.
Now, Tifa is featured in this music video. But the question everyone is asking, who is the owner? Her name is Khalia. And she's here to tell us right now. Khalia.
Hello.
Welcome.
Thank you for having me.
Well, good to have you in the flesh. I looked at your video.
You liked it?
And I like it.
Thanks.
I do. And so talk to us about your music, the journey so far.
Well, I recently moved back to Jamaica to kind of, you know, get some more inspiration. And I met the legendary Tone Kelly. So we've been working together since January on some new stuff. And this collaboration with Tifa is my first release with his label, so.
Okay, so you're residing?
In Jamaica, in Kingston, yeah.
No, but you were living in the UK.
Yeah, but I was born in Westmoreland, country girl, you know, so.
You were born in Westmoreland? And migrated to the UK when?
When I was six, but I've always been back and forth every year to see family, and like, I'm always here, you know?
Okay, so your music career started in the UK?
Yeah, I mean, I was recording, doing demos and stuff like that, but nothing like this, so mm-hmm. Coming here is the biggest inspiration to put stuff.
So you're only now getting serious about music as a career?
I've been serious. I've always wanted to, you know, but I haven't had serious people around me.
Okay.
You know, now I have a really great
Tony
team.
Tony Kelly.
Yeah, Tony Kelly. I have a really great team. You know, we have Rodney Hill doing A&R side. We have, you know, Dubshot doing stuff like that. So I've always wanted to do what I'm doing now. I just haven't had the people around me, and now I'm so grateful to have just an amazing team.
All right, so talk about your music now. What is it exactly? Is it dancehall? Is it hybrid? Is it reggae dancehall?
Yeah,
pop? What?
It's hybrid. It's because obviously I have influences from both backgrounds, so it's going to be hybrid. But I do want to bring dancehall to the world in a positive light from a female perspective. So I want to represent Jamaica. I want to represent dancehall to the world.
So you're aiming at the global mainstream?
Of course.
Wow.
Worldwide.
All right. Why not? I love it. Let's look at the video right here.
Body set good. What? Body set right. Hot. I want the D-E-A. Hey. Hot. I've never seen that one here come back. Whoa. Stepping at the dance, every man alive. Bump up a cup, baseline wide. Watch how me roll it, skirt ride. Ride, everything I ride. Them want see me pretty, yeah. Want know it's the if you pretty, yeah. Them a say I want me get a body there. My ex makes me sick. Ooh la la. The man them going crazy for it. Ooh la la. Them lose them mind, them crazy for it.
Me back it up and them wind to the floor. Watch how me twerk it, back to the core. And them in a frenzy, me cause uproar. Everything on your cap, nothing that score.
Hold on for me waistline too, cash. Shake up my body and my waist no more. Everybody in the war with the jump and spit, but me just a catch it with the bum and a tap.
See how I ain't up my body, me no need no man. So when me a bubble, go off of me and
I'm the rule the yard, me a the one dance. So if you want to see better, play it on time, yeah. Stepping at the dance, every man aligned.
Bump up a cup, waistline wine.
Watch how me roll it, skirt ride.
Ride, everything I ride.
Them want to see me pretty, yeah.
Why know it's the pretty, yeah.
Them a say I want me get the body there.
My ex makes me sick.
Ooh la la. The man them going crazy for me.
Ooh la la. Them lose them mind, them crazy for it.
Whiny, whiny, me love to whiny, yeah. The man them say oh me find me. Girl, when already can't stand up beside me. You hot, you know what to find me.
Boy, my heart like fire. Man them a watch me up in them desire, yeah. Move and I wind like wire. For the round and I roll, roll.
Me a plant it, look how me at. Them track style, me can't do me that.
Face well pretty and it's something never fat. But I'm bougie, lifestyle lock.
Hello. Stepping at the dance, every man aligned.
Bump up a cup, baseline wine.
Watch how me roll it, skirt ride.
Ride, everything I ride.
Them want see me pretty, yeah.
Want know it's the easy pretty, yeah.
Them a say I want me get the body there.
There you have it, right up, and she's getting love from our audience.
Thank you, guys.
Wow. Wow, you know, you look so scary in that, but right here you're so calm. I'm not afraid of you here, but I would be in that. So, all right, so that was done with the diva,
yes,
Tifa.
Now,
what was it like working with her?
It was amazing. It just happened. Like, she came into the studio, she had a session booked with Tony, and we kind of had the concept for the song already of like girls twerking. You know when we're twerking and the skirt's riding up and the, you know?
Yeah.
So we took inspiration from that, and we're looking at twerking from a different angle. Showed her the beat and she was like, this is sick and let's jump on it. And she's been like a big sister to me, kind of, because
okay.
I'm fresh, I'm new, so I'm kind of like, you know, she's been so motivational, like helping me with a lot of stuff. So it's been great working with her.
Oh, and how is it being received so far?
Everybody loves it. The girl, you like it, guys?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
I love it.
It's kind of like a ladies' anthem.
It's a lady. Like, even the video, like, it's female empowerment. You like, I'm a kid, don't mind them, man. Yeah.
Wow. All right. Well, we like it. I like it. So we look forward to when you come again.
Yes, definitely. I'll be here soon again.
Right, because it sounds like you're on your way, lady.
Thank
to
you.
Big things in music. And wow, would we even get an interview when you're an international superstar?
Of course.
Okay, I'm putting in my request right now. All right, sweetie, thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you.
Khalia, for coming and sharing with us. There you have her.
Thank you.
In this segment, Khalia, check her out. All right, so still to come right here on stage, we're going back to the 1990s.
One, you a boom, two, you a boom, boom.
With one of the generals of that era. And still to come, a cloud of controversy surrounding Vershon. And he will be here to clear the air. You don't want to miss that. And meet the son of Sizzla Kalonji, who is booked to perform, believe it or not, at the greatest reggae show on earth, Reggae Sumfest. And you don't even know him yet. All coming up. We'll be right back.
Mercy of God. Right now, I just the mercy of God. The mercy of God. The mercy of God. No, oh man, I go through. I just the mercy of God.
Reaching more and more screens around the world every week. On stage. So much more than entertainment.
Meleku is the son of Sizzla Kalonji.
What to make up this world?
He's a former student of Arden High School who is now pursuing a career in music and is set to make his debut, believe it or not, at Reggae Sumfest, the greatest reggae show on earth. Meleku.
Greetings, Winfrey.
Blessed sir. Welcome. Good to meet you.
Yes, sir.
When did you start doing music?
Well, we always had a love for music, you know, but
yes.
In our younger years, we were more geared towards sports, you know what I mean? And we had a lot of people around us doing music, like my father, my cousin. So after a while, the love for music just grew, and I just began to pursue it at about age 16.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it was sports?
Yeah,
you were more at first. What kind of sports? What
football,
were you playing?
Man.
Football?
Oh, yeah, Jamaican football.
So the passion was with that?
Yes, sir.
But some interest in music?
Yes, I always had a love for music, but it's almost like I rediscovered it.
Okay, and at what stage? After school? Before school? What?
No, when we were in school. While I was at Arden, I was doing recordings with my cousin. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So I would go to my cousin's studio, to my father's studio, do recordings, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. None of which I really took too serious at the time. You know what I mean? But
it was just moonlighting.
Yeah. But just there, explore the thing and just see what I go on. But then people only just tell us, say, we have a vibe, so we just decide, say, I take it up professionally.
Okay, so we have a lyric video lined up at the moment.
Yes, sir.
What can you tell us about it before we go to it?
Yeah, it's a song called Right Place, you know what I mean? Dedicated to all the beautiful empresses out there.
It's your first release?
Yes, it was the first release.
All right, so let's go to it right here on the screen.
Always. Always. Whoa. I say we at the right place, girl. I say we at the right place, girl. Never gonna waste your love. 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 Empress don't haste in love. Empress don't haste in love. You feel you have some faith in love. Cause we at the right place in love.
We at the right.
Queen feel really know every sense. Evident royalty she represent. How you define intelligence? Your presence powerful like presidents. Every dance you perform for me yet again. Many spread false rumors we never end. If your rules can't break, well it have you bent. You have me oxygen. Never gonna waste your love. 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 Empress don't haste in love. Empress don't haste in love. If you have some faith in love, cause we at the right place in love. Say we at the right. Fool you once, not fool you twice. I'ma see ya, you through my headlights. Yes, she have the eye revive. One night, trust the flames ignite. Let go, baby girl, let life. Stress free, drama free, best time. Yeah, me want to give you a time. Me just might. I say we at the right.
I say we at the right. I say we at the right.
The right place?
Right place.
Right place. That's the title of that one from Meleku. The son of Sizzla Kalonji. Now, is the music dancehall, roots reggae, just reggae what? How do you describe, how do you define what you're doing? Because this is only one song we're hearing.
True.
And it sounds like it's a cross between singing and DJing.
Well, to be honest, I don't really like to define it. You know what I mean? I don't like to place it in a box and try to limit myself. But in terms of genre, I would say I'm somewhere around a dancehall, roots rockish kind of person, because I have a love for reggae, you know what I mean, being who my father is.
Yes.
But I also have a love for dancehall as well. Yes. Especially when it's done correctly.
Because that's him. He's both.
Yeah, he's both. You know what I mean? Yes. So I just beat around those, you know what I mean?
Okay. So where would you say your music is at this time? In terms of your recordings and what exposure have you gotten so far?
Well, I've had the privilege to grace Sumfest small stage before, you know what I mean?
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, and I've been doing shows abroad, like Reggae and River. Been doing a couple club shows in the United States, so I'll be getting a good exposure.
Oh, so you've been rolling with your dad?
Most definitely. I just departed from the Life of a Ghetto Youth tour, powered by Vast Productions in the United States. It was a month tour.
Yes.
We toured a couple states in the United States, and you know, it was a good vibe. I was the youngest one on the tour, alongside people like Sizzla, Marlon Asher, Pressure, Rash Rilo. Okay.
So what role is he playing in your career, Sizzla?
Pupa.
Pupa? Pupa role? Only?
So I call him, man.
Yeah. So he...
He's like a mentor, you know what I mean? He's someone who I can go to and him just tell me straight up what's wrong, you know what I mean? My performances, my delivery, everything like that, you know what I mean? Him show me how to really conquer certain things.
Yes.
You know what I mean? And just in terms of thus, a lot of insight into the industry. You know what I mean? In terms of direction and where to go. You just steer me, you know?
Oh, great.
Most definitely.
So you're set at Sumfest. Will it be during his set or you're on your own?
I'm on my own. I'm out there on my own right now.
Okay. So you won't be like coming right before him?
No.
No? Not
right before him. But the same night.
That's all?
The same night.
And you won't be appearing with him? Maybe?
Maybe.
And you do that sometimes, do you?
Yes, we do that.
All right. Well, you know, what we're going to do then, we're not going to ask you anything more. We're going to leave the rest until you come again.
Most definitely.
Or post Sumfest or at Sumfest.
Mm.
So for right now, Meleku, thanks for coming, sir. It's great meeting you. Next time you're here, you might have to come live on our set and,
most definitely,
and deal with it. What do you say?
Anything the people they want, I'm ready for them.
You're ready for them?
Anything them.
All right, sir. Thank you. All right, there you have him. Meleku, the son of Sizzla Kalonji. And we soon stop saying that, the son of, because he's going to be his own artist, I suspect. Okay, so still to come right here on stage, we'll be going back live to the glory days of dancehall with one of the generals of that era. A cloud of controversy surrounding the name Vershon. He'll be here to clear it.
Right now, I'm just the mercy of God.
And more, all coming up right here on our stage.
One, you a boom, two, you a boom, boom. Three, four, you a boom, down the place, boom.
Reaching more and more screens around the world every week. On stage, so much more than entertainment.
From his ongoing feud with fellow artist Jamil to baby mama drama and most recently his choice of clothing, it seems as if our guest in this segment is covered under a cloud of controversy. Controversy that he seeks to address right now, right here on our stage, once and for all. Vershon is who we are talking about right now on our stage. Vershon.
Wagwan.
Blessed love, sir.
My dear, man. Yeah, dear.
Good to see you as usual.
Did I realize?
And you seem to be in a good spirit.
Right.
Very good.
We have life, so.
Okay. You know, the few don't have you.
No, man. Not like that, man. Not like that. Vershon always humble, you know. And in a real life, me really don't want to talk much about the feud because that's the past, you get me? Mm-hmm. I'm see them spread one little rumor and say, them bought me up in a airport and me run out breathing heavily into nearby bushes. And yeah, look at drama, me I say, watch that. That's the best them could have done. You get me? So me just want to leave them alone.
So you're just laughing at
them? Yeah.
Because it's ridiculous. Okay, what about the baby mama drama?
All right, well, it's still in front of the court, you know, so me can't talk much about it. You get me? It all depends upon what you want to know or what the people want.
Family court.
To know.
You're in the family court right. For maintenance.
Well, not maintenance. Restraining order, I think.
Oh, you're being restrained from the baby or from the.
Well, me know if I'm from she or from the baby, because I don't really see none of them, so I don't really know.
Oh, you're not allowed to see any of them?
No.
And you're fighting?
Well, I decided not to see the baby because this girl is a problem girl, so I just say, all right then. In order, I just say.
Oh, you're not officially barred from seeing
no,
the child.
I just mean so I don't want to see him, but me make sure I get everything like every week.
But so, isn't that difficult for you not to be
able
to see
wait till
child?
When him grow up, man. I can't bother the stress and the drama. I'm fed up of it. I'm tired of it. Enough people who don't know what me I got through them just see the smile and say, yeah, maybe I am the problem or this and that. I just say, sure. Can't bother you, man. Can't bother the mix up and leap at talky people, you see me?
Okay. All right. Well, we hope you will be there as a father for your child.
Always.
Always.
I'm going to grow up, man.
But your presence is important.
Yeah, but I don't think she realized that. And she probably feel like she do something to hurt me. She not hurt me, she hurt the baby.
Okay.
I'm gonna try to reach out to her many a times and she don't reply.
I suspect she's a young person like yourself. And we hope now that the public, more bigger public, I hear about it.
Which is right.
Somebody will be able to talk to her and she will understand that the child is most important.
Well, right many people talk to her and she still don't change. It's the same thing, so.
Well, okay. Well, let's pray for her and the child. All right. So you're also in some controversy about clothing that you wear. Your clothing. What's that?
All right. I was just wearing the jacket as a reminder of where black people coming from, but I guess many took the piss at it. You get me? But this, them say every day is a learning lesson, and this only proved to me how ignorant black people are among themselves. Because remember, you know, them say each one teach one.
Yes.
You probably know what the jacket mean, and I don't. Instead of you jump to criticize, why not just tell me? Because even the teacher that teaches still learning.
So we're talking about the Confederate flag. On a jacket.
Yes.
And that's the Confederate are the people in the southern United States.
Mm-hmm.
Who didn't want slavery to end.
First thing, me not try to justify the jacket or anything.
No, I'm just trying to communicate to our audience.
What if I didn't know? Yeah. What if I didn't know?
But did you or did you not know?
As what me said earlier, I was just wearing the jacket as a reminder of where we're coming from.
So you did know?
Right.
So you're wearing it as a mark of protest?
I think people them kind of exaggerate over the whole situation.
Okay.
You get me? But we don't pay that no mind. That's that, and that's the past, and me not aware about the jacket again. The awareness of it is very good, you know, because remember, you know, that's an American history, you know. So, me see that same jacket I sell in Jamaica. I saw rings and stuff like that where many youth don't
being
know what
that here right. In Jamaica.
Many youths right now don't know what that flag mean. You get me, I say. So the awareness of it is good.
We're glad that you are bringing some attention to what's
Which
going on
right.
in Jamaica, because I didn't even know that Jamaicans are selling that flag.
I bought that in a store right here in Jamaica.
I wonder if people take the time out to find out what's the whatever is on their clothing and what they're wearing as branding.
Well, no people...
If they understand what it means, some of them. Let's talk about music now. Where do you stand right now?
All right, I have a new song called My Success, produced by me, mm-hmm. / Glenn Devon, doing very well. Just shoot the video like last week. So, yeah, man, it's going good.
It's a new video.
Right.
And we have it queued up now. Let's look at it before we go any further.
Me a save off, work round the clock, me not take no day off. Better must come, say that fi pay off. Do me wanna think so me a me wanna. And me pay my own bills them. Take care of me own children. Me success it alone, I kill them. Them see the Benz wait till them see the house.
Okay, that's a brand new one from Vershon. What's the title?
My Success.
It's that new. ladies and gentlemen. Okay, so the audience seems to be giving us an early approval.
In our real life.
And that will go for the rest of the wider audience out there. And you just released a song a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah, a song called Wet for the Ladies, produced by Vershon Records, yeah. Come on, make you wet,
wet, wet. That too is doing well?
Yeah, man, that's a going good, man.
So overall, where would you say your career is now in relation to your objectives, where you want to get it to?
I'm not lie to you. I kind of get distracted with the whole feud because everybody knows that is not Vershon. And okay. I see myself way bigger than that. I think people see me way bigger than that. And a whole
part. I am one of them?
Yes, definitely.
Okay.
And a whole lot of people tell me, yo, me disappointed, you know, because you never there for God. But sometimes you have to find that in a life. Only part things come through you and you just have to get back up. You get me? I know the fall where you're falling is. Where you're doing your fall, you get back up.
And because that's a great song too, this one.
Yeah, man.
And that's where we want to see you, sir. And that focus is maintained.
Right.
And even if I'm going to mess with you, the amount of tune out there carry you.
I leave them alone.
You can just smile at that.
Because, I mean, Clash thing not really going away right now. The people are not upon that. People want money, have fun and party, man. And I write the same thing.
Okay, so in terms of what your summer looking like, anything big, important coming up?
Well, mostly overseas, shows overseas. I have a 1 month tour leaving this Friday, 1 month tour in Europe.
Okay.
Yeah.
Are you able to go to the US?
Yeah.
You have no visa issue anywhere?
No problem at all.
So you can do UK, Canada, and the US?
Anywhere at all.
Okay, well, keep it that way.
Yeah, that me at all.
Keep it that way. That sounds good because we don't need it. Unneeded, especially the new generation of Jamaican artists are needed to carry the music on.
Yeah.
Because foreigners are doing it, dancehall and all, in mainstream. So, in the meantime, then, Virgie.
Respect you.
Thank you, you know. We come through and talk to you. We are watching you. We are watching you. Yeah, go out with. And you sleep again. We are calling you out. Thank you, though, for coming and all the very best.
Respect.
All right, and still to come right here on stage, we're going back to the 1990s. And we'll be live with one of the generals of that decade. Yes, and there's a live audience to take it all in. Right here on stage when we come back.
Reaching more and more screens around the world every week. On stage, so much more than entertainment.
The decade of the 1990s is widely believed to be the glory days of dancehall. This, as the beats and lyrics of the era are the most visited, most sampled body of work in the genre. You think it a go so when I hold you tonight? One of the generals of the 1990s is Degree, who will refresh our memories on his incredible contribution to the decade. And that will be live. But first, where is General Degree right now in music? General.
Bless up.
Blessed love, sir. Blessed love.
Yeah, man.
Okay, so before you answer that, remind us of when it was that you get the big breakout. What year was it?
1992.
It was 92.
With a song called Granny.
Granny was the breaker. Yeah.
The song was never supposed to come out.
Really?
Yeah, me beg the producer not to release it.
Why?
Never like it. So like old lady, I never my style. Like. I just joke me a joke when me do Granny, there's a joke around, you know.
So you were just in the studio, freestyling?
No, that's just at home. Everybody, you know, Tiger did have a song called When, and everybody have this voice thing. And I remember my sister always talk like Granny around the house. And me have the lyrics. I'm sorry, I'm just flip it. I'm just doing it for the joke. Do it, Danny. My voice the song. There's hope I'll mistake another song, you know, will become a hit, you know.
Danny Brownie, where?
Yeah, Danny Brownie. And when we voice the song and we go country, them telling me they live a man. And I think about it. And I said, no, so I don't want a song come out so like an old lady.
Yes.
I'm just gonna call Danny. I said, Danny, because don't put out a song.
You were in character. You were playing a character.
Yeah, that's a joke.
You weren't yourself in there.
That's a be a joke because I was a hardcore DJ.
Same. But weren't you still in school at that time?
No, I was out of school.
I was finished.
Out of school. I was like doing the tailoring, I mean. I was just finished, like, stop sewing and just say, all right, I'm going to take music serious.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so how did you transition out to become a serious artist? What was the follow-up? Right.
Well, before Granny, I used to do tailoring, right? And when I went to England as a young artist, and when we really realized how The plane ride, nice, all them things there. Yeah,
but just... You want in war?
Yeah, but just come back and just put on the scissors on the side, say, so, you know, done with tailoring.
Yes.
So I just take up music serious and doing a lot of music, and everybody hear me as a little MAGA youth. Every big producer hear me, from Dave Kelly, Tony Kelly, Danny Brownie, Bobby Digital, everybody want voice me call them. Said, no, this little boy, yeah. I remember walking to Bobby Digital studio one day and I said, man, and I said, Bobby, look around. And I said, I couldn't believe who said, man, a while ago.
Yes.
And him said, no, you go back through the door and come back in again. I'm going to go through the door and come up and say, man, again. And him said, jeez. Come on, boys, you know, it don't look like home sound.
Mm-hmm. Mm. And those names you're calling, those great producers,
yes.
They are the producers now whose work...
Yeah, is well known.
Wow. The sampling is phenomenal.
From Steely and Cleavey, Danny Brown.
Everybody is going into that era to refresh catalogs.
Yes.
Mainstream artists, international mainstream artists and all. What does it mean to you to be part of that 90s, which is now being called in some circles the golden era of dance?
Well, I feel proud to know that I'm one of the column them, yes, so to speak, who really... put dancehall, 90s dancehall on the map, because when me boss, as I say, me tell the producer not to release my song, mm-hmm, because me no want to sound like a granny, and I beg him twice from full callbacks and said, don't put out my song, don't put out my song, don't put out my song. And he said, Degree, just give me a chance. First time you hear my song on the radio, I'm ashamed now. Me, the
you shame on yourself.
Yeah, man, the opportunity, and the beside a man who sell, you know, one of them seller, we call them, vendor. And that's a vibe, because I just stand up half a tree. And I just hear the song come on. And I start look around and I start holding my head. And I'm here. Worst what make me now feel away now is when I see the man stop where I do. And put his head close to the radio. I say, oh, what is? Because I might hear this old lady sing and them thing there. This old lady voice. And I just start walking and holding my head and walking, because I said, ja. So, but I want to tell you, win for everywhere we go. I hear the song I play. For about 20 minutes, you know, because when the song come on for the first time I hear, you know, as you know,
yes,
when Granny come on, it was like a...
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
It was a comic relief for all of us.
Yeah,
and
everywhere.
So where are you now, sir, in music?
Still love the music. We never stop yet. I just vibe song regularly. So me hear song already when me no remember me do.
Because you're still very active, yeah, as an artist.
Yeah,
you're always...
Yeah, I love.
I've seen you in the airport all the time, all going off.
I'm a big fan of General Degree now.
Yes.
He's a fan of myself. So me check myself, and when I write a song, me say, would I, you know, want show or want stage show and listen to me and sing that? Mm. So me analyze and assess my thing.
And you're a fan of you?
I'm a fan of General Degree.
Okay, good. So where are some of the places you've been going?
Panama, Costa Rica.
Yes.
You name it.
And the last time I saw you were going to... Costa Rica, I think.
Costa Rica?
Maybe. Some Central America place, yeah, where...
What about people?
They don't even speak English.
Right, yes. And that is what a song like Traffic Blocking do for me, because me tell a person, say, my biggest competition, when I say no, if you compete against is Traffic Blocking. That song is still so big that I don't even know how to do a song for go around that.
Okay.
That's how me have to compete with my own song, just for tribe. Because Traffic Blocking still playing at every club in America, in Central America, everywhere, every night, somewhere, mm-hmm, every night. So it's a song when we close show with it. When we go Europe, when we go anywhere outside of Jamaica, from the rhythm, come on, it's a new song.
It's a dancehall classic and a signature for you. So all right. So we're gonna go back to the 90s, sir.
Okay.
But first, we want to just release.
Right, premiere, world premiere.
We're going to world premiere, a brand new one for you. Let's go.
A little close.
All right. Come and let me take you on a pleasure journey. Road boy style, where me have you a go learn, eh? Say you love me, and that concern me. Dance with me, love how you a twist and you a turn, eh? La 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 la. No girl can't step in on your shoes, no day. La 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 la. Girl, bring your sexy body, come my way.
This time, I'll get a little bolder.
Yo, yo.
This time, we'll dance a little closer. Wine slow for me, please, my shot. Drinks up to the body. I can tell what you want when you touch me. Hold me down, tell me now that you love me. I don't like my time wasted. Just forward your location. Only for you, one passion. Your flavor, amazing. Your friends be low-key haters. Them girls just a prey for your downfall.
only girl in my company. And tell me, say you love me. Tell me, say you love me. Looking so pretty, girl, you light up the city. When I say your bum bum, you get me tricky, girl. Tell me, say you love me. Tell me, say you love me.
This time, I'll get a little bolder.
Yeah, yeah.
This time, we'll dance a little closer. For me, please, my shot. Drinks up, titty money. I can tell what you want when you touch me. Hold me down, tell me now that you love me. Wine slow for me, please, my shiny. Drinks up, titty money. I can tell what you want when you touch me. Hold me down, tell me now that you love me.
Girl, tell me, say you love me.
Hold me down, tell me now that you love me.
Girl, tell me, say you love me. Tell me, say you love me.
Hold me down, tell me now that you love me.
Tell me, say you love me.
Hold me down, tell me now that you love me.
Bubble up and then you simmer down. Shake it up and jerk it up, turn everything around.
A little closer. Wow, you like it already, right? You like it, nice. I like it too.
Thank you.
And you're working out with Kingston, right?
Kingston, yeah, he's an artist who is amongst Fat Joe Terror Squad. Mm-hmm. And yeah, bad singer, as you can hear him vocals, him bad. And he's a Jamaican, he's from Manchester.
But he's based in the US.
Yeah, he's lived here from a little youth, 10 year old.
So is it getting love yet?
No, track? Are you first played it now?
Yeah.
And the song will come out, yeah.
The world just has to the song
just as the video, yeah.
Wow, where next are you going?
Montreal Reggae Festival, August 19, Canada. Mm-hmm. I have a couple things in the pipeline. And I have two more videos to do in Miami again. Or two other singles, our videos to do in Panama. See how.
Well, we're going to give you the stage right now, saying, and let you remind, especially those who are too young to have been around and remember the 1990s, how you took the place apart and why you are one of the generals of the 1990s, sir.
Respect.
So, when we come back, that will be happening right here on our stage. General degree, we don't miss that.
Reaching more and more screens around the world every week. On stage, so much more than entertainment.
And we're ready now to go back to the 1990s with one of the generals of the era, General Degree.
Yes. Big up Tropical. Yeah. And all on stage, ladies. TV Land. All right. Memory Lane. Yeah, yo.
We dey on stage. Number one. Me a go tell you some things. A whole heap of things. A bag of things. A crocus bag of things. We a go chat some things. We gonna hear some things. A bag of things. What my ladies them at now? All of the girl them who know say them got it. Show me a signal from you a wapi de. Suit where you in a city. Boot where fi match it. One. Ya girl, she no left a door up, no careless, she lucky there. Naff man a give you number, but you dash it. You know each up at the same place every Saturday. Wow, ya girl. My beautiful ladies, can I hear you scream? Down, them there here.
Ma,
my girls them don't keep bad company.
Ma,
my girls them don't soup low fee money.
Ma,
my girls just put up your hands, make me see.
Ma,
my girls them full of quality. So when they ask them, who the inner the good girl posse? You then broke out, went out and get wassy. Boy, who the inner the broke down? Come on, one like them act as I want a new chassis. Who the inner the borrow clothes? All right. Big on the man in the place. Okay. The one who will overtake care of them ladies. You know why? How we no boring now. How that she likes to find me interesting. Put me before him. Oh. So I complain and I say we are the best thing.
What make you think who my love be employ? Them get the best of them always enjoy. Come on a big man, no one boy. Now nah, do nothing for destroy. The kind of world be win up, you man and me boss. Half of them, they what they want me to do, a chop grass. If we owe me a one and a handle the war cross. They be here and tell me, say, fit up when me a pass. Sicker that me happy tell, Sharon, say, me lost. Walk till 9 o'clock and then collect the little boss. 10 o'clock I come, so me have to check Jackie fast. Call me a, me not walk it in a wood. Call we not boring, no. I don't see like to find me in. She put me before him, oh. Ah!
You remember this one? I'm gonna take you down to memory lane. Real memory lane. I know you remember this. Sing along with me.
I know this beautiful girl named Faye. She came to check me while I was at work one day. She said, Degree, I know that you're a musician. Won't you introduce me to the boys in your band? I said, meet my drummer and my guitarist. Here is my bassist and my vocalist. But when I introduced the girl to my pianist, she said, Degree, you know I got to woo. She said, she want the pianist. She said, she need a pianist. She just a cry for the pianist. She woulda die for the who sing now pim 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 pam all night long. She wanted pianist to play her favorite song. Pim 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 pam all night long. She wanted pianist to play her favorite. And today, let it go tropical.
Memory Lane. Big up Wilford Williams. Big up the ladies them again, right?
Man, she want a man in her life. A man fi make she feel nice. You hear? Ah, boy, she want fi feel nice. She say fi Mr. Tweet, alright. Whoa, Mr. Tweet nice. Say a fi the girl dem. Tweet nice already, as she come back again. Mr. Tweet nice. Say a fi the girl dem. Tweet nice already, as she come back again. Lord, boy, she want a body guard. Whoa, Lord. Want a man fi guard her yard. She send fi a good bodyguard. Lord boy, she want a bodyguard.
Give me some more tempo. Give me more tempo. Never see if you remember this.
I could have who said, granny no miserable. If you live with your granny, you eat on granny too. I who said, granny no love the cousin. Baby granny, she cost me everything. Granny,
stop bothering out me name.
Granny,
you calling me name in vain.
Granny,
where you want call me for? We love the
Ladies, some more tempo. More tempo. Ladies, when you have a good man and you want to keep him, guess what to do?
I just the other day a girl whisper in my ears. I tell me say good man shot nowadays. She wonder if I leave them girl live in a cave. And she never knew it would have reached this year state. So girl take me advice before me go me ways. The best thing me say you fit out, go home, go bail. Put on your clothes, pop on the front page. Any good man you see, and him girl friend a gaze. Grab on pan him, hang on pan him. Hold on pan him, my man just get take way. Lay down pan him, sit down pan him. If I that you fit out, you not.
One, you a boom, two, you a boom, boom. Three, four, you a boom, down the place, boom. You have man heart to beat, boom, boom. One, you a boom, two, you a boom, boom. Three, four, you a boom, down the place, boom. You have man heart to beat, boom, boom.
Hold on with that again. You think it's a go-go, so when I hold you tonight, I want to hold at it. So you can see it, don't believe me. Give me the chance to quiet with. Who no time now, think it's a go-go surrender. I grind the holiday. So you can see it, don't believe me. Give me the chance to quiet with. Why when man and no man go pan boho, them always have something a probe. Man a go a rough like say him can load. Woman a say she a go blow a man fuse. Just what day something me discover. Pan the fool me a chat to me lover. Two a we arguments saucy like pepper. I tell we one another which one are we bother. She say we a the little more you little bugger. Me just jam a steam fish we give power. With banana ya plantin a flower. So when I hold your little eye going. Me just hang up and rust with the shower. Get myself together, everything well cover. Think of the car in the next half hour. What I make an answer, me sell it up. You think it's a go-go surrender?
I go on the holiday, so you can see it. Give me the chance, I go on. You think it's a go-go somewhere now? I go on the holiday, so you can see it. Give me the chance, I go on.
Wanna ready again? Wanna ready again? Huh? Wanna ready?
Yeah. Ready? Yeah. Ready? Whoa, traffic blocking. Gotta come down in our tights and stocking. Watch out, them your style. And the dress code ever. Serious thing. Traffic blocking. Gotta come down in our. Watch out them your style. And the dress code ever. Bomb red and fling. Put in a the air from you can block traffic. Every woman out there who knows say them got it. If one day we got it, you hold them a traffic. And we hear some sing up on the yota. The way out she look from a far me spot it. A pistol fast I'll do me did a crack it. Draw down gear in a me automatic. All my beautiful ladies now. Traffic blocking. Get a come down in a. Watch out them your style and the dress code ever. Yeah. Ready? Yeah. Ready? You're dancing about that. Yeah. Ready?
I feel black candy.
Yeah. We want to win for DJ. All right, turn up on the loud, turn up on the loud. All right, then now drop it, black it. Gotta come down here. We.
Tropical. Wow. What can I tell you? Thank you so much, Degree.
Yeah, man, respect.
For that walk down memory lane.
Yeah, man, thanks.
Inside of the 1990s.
Yeah.
And give it up for your audience, your fans and yours.
Thank you.
Give it up. And DJ Tropical.
Big up, DJ Tropical.
Big up. All right, so with that, we say so long. Thank you for joining us. Do join us again next week for more right here on stage. And you could never tell what will be happening right here.
Yeah, Give them the, we'll fall, better.
Tropical.
Yeah. Waterloo.
All right. You know, it's a beautiful time here, and we enjoy ourselves, and you don't know, what can I say, Winford? What we didn't talk about? We didn't talk about, oh, you're still at that? What time still at that? All right, give me a seat.
Give me a seat. Give me a new style. Give me a freestyle on it. Give me something new, Panarini.
New style? All right. Come and say. Bumper in every gal, bumper in, boy. From Sizzla Kalonji, big bumper thing, yeah. Bumper